Hey everyone, my name is Seth Persigel, callsign KK4TEE, and today I'll be demonstrating how to deorbit and land a rocket by using the kOS mod for Kerbal Space Program. In the first video, we built a rocket, learned some of the features of kOS, and flew a rocket into orbit. Now, we're going to land a rocket that could have been launched using that very same program. Oh, and we're going to land it propulsively. That's right, no parachutes. Like the previous program, we're going to break this up into manageable chunks and then run through them one at a time until the program is successful. Feel free to download my sample code and follow along, as well as practice making changes to it. If you're not sure what something does or why a value is the way it is, experiment and see what happens. This script is a little more complicated than the last, but as we add complexity, we gain capabilities. Let's go over the game plan for our program. First, kOS should change the ship's orbit into a stable, circular, low-carbon orbit. Making the orbit constant between landings helps us to ensure that the craft lands near the same spot of ground each time. We'll change the orbit using two burns, one at apoapsis and one at periapsis. Once the orbit is circularized at the parking altitude, the script will wait until it's over the proper longitude to drop the periaps into the atmosphere and begin the descent. We'll set the specific longitude based on trial and error. Next, the ship will hold facing retrograde until it is time to fire the engines and then gently touch down. Alright, now that we have a plan, let's get to it. We'll start by creating a new file and writing a header containing a description of what the code should do once we are finished. This is really useful if you frequently have a bunch of tabs open, or are looking through a group of files you haven't worked with in a while. Next, we'll take care of the user-defined parameters that we can use to tune and test our script. Landing orbit altitude is the altitude of the circular parking orbit in meters. Deorbit burn LNG is the longitude that we will start the deorbit burn at, and entry periapsis is the target periapsis for the deorbit burn. After that, we'll put the ship into a known state, just like in the previous video, with the added line of panels on, which will open the solar panels for us. The next step is to set the variables that deal with latitude and longitude, such as our landing target. First, let's set a variable KSC launchpad to be the latitude and longitude of the launchpad. My goal is that this script should be good enough to get us within around 100 kilometers or so of the KSC, which will be really nice for recovering funds in campaign mode. Note that a lat-long variable is a special kind of list that only has two values, latitude first, then longitude. Also remember that set updates the variable only once, while lock updates it every time it is called upon. Locking ship lat-long to ship geoposition gives the ship's current location on the surface of the planet. The reason I set a variable like this is twofold. First, it can sometimes be easier to remember or modify a custom variable. Secondly, and more importantly, is that some of the system variables in kOS can't be printed directly to the screen, or have other special rules. If you have a problem with reading a system variable that you can't quite figure out, it's usually worth a try to set a custom variable to that value and then read that instead. Moving along, I create the surface elevation variable, which gives me the height of the ground beneath the ship relative to sea level. Then, I create better alt radar to hold the ship's altitude above the surface. This is a habit I picked up from playing with the real solar system mod, because the stock method, alt radar, can sometimes return incorrect data when real solar system is installed. The custom variable impact time then uses better alt radar to calculate how long it will take to hit the ground at the current speed, while not really accounting for drag or gravity. Calculating the thrust to weight ratio of the ship is done by first defining gravity using the gravitational constant, as well as the mass and radius of the planetary body the ship is orbiting. The nice thing about using an equation instead of just defining gravity as 9.81 meters per second is that it will automatically change based on the planet you are currently in orbit of. After that, I lock the TWR of the craft to the maximum thrust of the ship divided by mass times gravity. I use a max function to prevent the TWR from ever reading zero, which could possibly cause a situation where the script tries to divide by zero, which would be bad, okay? With those blocks taken care of, we can start getting back to code that looks familiar from last time. We'll set the run mode variable to start out higher than we did before, so that if in the future we decide to combine scripts, we don't have to worry about getting the run modes all mixed up. I also went ahead and added a check that makes testing easier. If the current orbit already meets the requirements for our parking orbit, it'll go ahead and skip altering it and just go ahead and use it. Now that the setup is taken care of, we can get to the real meat of the program, the run modes. Remember, an until loop like we have here will run until the requirement is true. So for us, that means the program will run until the run mode equals zero. Also keep in mind that proper formatting is essential to having readable code. A general rule of thumb is that every time you open a new statement, indent another level. Every time you close out a statement, reduce the indent. Let's kick things off with run mode 20. This mode simply time warps to just before the apoapsis, provided that the ship is above the atmosphere. Once there is less than 60 in-game seconds until apoapsis, kOS will slow the game back down to regular speed and move to run mode 21. If the ship hits the atmosphere, the program will end, giving control of the ship back to the Kerbal. Run mode 21 waits until just 5 seconds before apoapsis and then burns retrograde until the periapsis is below the target parking orbit. Notice here that you can use formulas for the values. The one I use lowers the throttle from 100% to 10% based on how close the periapsis is to the target. This helps to immensely improve the accuracy of the burns. Once the burn is complete, run mode 22 time warps until just before the periapsis. I use 60 seconds as my margin to allow enough time for the game to gradually slow down the time warp, which at level 3 takes about 30 to 40 seconds of in-game time. This usually leaves just enough time for the ship to spin around to wherever I need it to point, which in this case is retrograde. Here's another possible glitch you might experience. Using kOS's lock steering feature can be a little twitchy. It usually works okay, but sometimes freaks out or starts oscillating while staying in place. If this happens to you, try using different combinations of RCS, enabling or disabling reaction wheels and engine gimbals, and if you're in the atmosphere, winglets and control surfaces. There is also another way of steering called raw control. This is where you basically program when to press the WASD keys. It takes a little while to get the hang of, but I plan on explaining it better in another video. Moving on, run mode 23 burns to lower the apoapsis to the target transfer orbit altitude, just like run mode 21 did for the periapsis, with one added stop criteria. It also tries to detect if the apoaps and periapsis are getting too close to each other, as this can cause them to switch places. After this completes, the ship should be in an almost circular orbit and will then time warp using run mode 24. Here we start needing those geolocation variables that we set up at the beginning of the program. You can call just the longitude of a geolocation by using the LNG suffix after the variable name. The same works for latitudes using LAT. Here, kOS will deactivate the time warp once the current longitude is within 10 degrees of the target burn coordinates. This margin needs to be large enough to allow time warp to gradually slow down, while also small enough to not bore you to death. Once the ship is close to the right spot, run mode 25 starts and waits for the ship to pass the exact burn longitude, and then starts a gentle burn at half throttle. The more accurate we are here, the better the accuracy we'll have upon landing. I've also added a bit of code that will dramatically eject the service module once the burn is complete. Feel free to delete or comment out these lines if your ship doesn't need this feature. Now, it's time for more time warping using run mode 26. Since the ship is about to enter the atmosphere, it's time to pull the solar panels back in with the command panels off. It's also time to switch from orbital velocity readings to surface velocity. Here you can see that lock steering doesn't just work with the headings or retrograde, you can also add other vectors as well, including the inverse of the surface velocity. Moving along, the program will warp until the ship hits the atmosphere and then coast while pointing retrograde relative to the surface. That is until the ship is just about ready to start the final touchdown burn. We determine when this is by testing to make sure that there are less than 100 seconds until impacting the ground, that the ship is moving downwards, and that we're less than 5 kilometers above the surface. Once all of these criteria are met, run mode 27 brings us to the final few moments of flight. Here, I'll be using a burn similar to a suicide burn, but having a reduced intensity. The goal of this burn should be to bring the ship's velocity to almost zero, just as the ship is touching down on the surface. There are many different strategies for this depending on how you value the trade-offs between fuel efficiency, safety margins, G-forces on your crew, stability, and so forth. I try to strike a balance between them and hold speed once I get to 5 meters a second just above the surface. This is probably one of the areas most ripe for experimentation and tuning. I've also tried to demonstrate that kOS can use math other than just addition and multiplication. You can also perform powers operations, as well as square roots. Have fun with it, and watch out for missing parentheses. After the main loop, we have the same throttle and visualization code as the first video, copied and pasted, with the addition of a couple extra useful bits, such as ETA to periapsis, our new impact time calculation, and finally the ship's current latitude and longitude. Now, before I conclude the video and show the full program running, I'd like to know your thoughts and if there's a specific subject you would like me to cover. If there is, please leave it in the comments below. Alright, that's enough prep work. Let's get those Kerbals back onto solid ground.